Hi everyone, thank you for joining me for this new experimentation video. This is, I think, the fourth or the fifth one which I did in a row on the same day, but you will not see all the videos on the same day, so this is still the same day when I did video one, and there will pop up cards here in this video every now and then if you like to check out the other videos for my experiments and technique trial and error things that I did that day. Here you can see all the paints that I've used for the entire project series. I did not use all the paints in this video here, but more or less all the paints that were left over from the other projects. The further my projects progress, the more PVA glue I've added to the paint, just to change their consistency and to experiment what actually happens to the color when it dries, if it changes the color texture, if it does nothing at all, just to test out if this might be an alternative for a pour medium, as this is way cheaper than the flow tool is, but I expect it will not work. So the flow tool is still my go-to medium when it comes to acrylic pouring. And as a small side note, if you're interested, I have listed all the materials that I'm using in the description box below. It is linked to my German Amazon site, so if you're not from Germany, they might not be of so much good for you, but at least you can check them out if you have something similar. If you're from the US, you're going to have a store on your Amazon site, which is called Sargent Art, Sargent like the painter, which in a way looks like my Artina store, so probably you can use the colors from them. They have somewhat similar acrylic paints from the same price range, so test it out. Once I have figured out the Amazon.com affiliate program, I will be adding the links there as well, but not there yet. If you want to support my channel anyways, you will have a PayPal link down there. You can use my Etsy store if you want to go and grab some of my works for yourself. We'll be happy. But now let's continue with the project. And as I said, I still had some paints left from my previous projects that I did. And I really do not want to waste paint. And before I throw any paint away, I rather experiment with it. Because most of the times you can just reuse a canvas if it was a failure. So you can just wipe it off and clean the canvas again, or let it dry and re-pour something over it. And I would rather do this instead of wasting paint. Because everything costs money, and when you get some new insights out of it from your experimentation, why not? This is also the reason why I'm sharing everything, just because so that you do not have to experiment. Or if there was any questions that you had in mind which were not answered in any other videos, perhaps I can tell you something that was new and untested before, I don't know. In the very beginning, when I was starting this rest paint experiment video that I'm doing here, I just decided to put a white paper on top of my previous used surface, as this was already quite messy looking, and I did not want to have you staring at a messy surface all the time. It is going to be messy anyways, right after the first pour, but at least it looks a bit cleaner in the very beginning of the video. So just a white paper, so it is going to buckle as soon as it's getting red from the paint, but just for now, let's pretend it's going to be pretty. So the very first thing that I wanted to attempt, as I had paint from almost all the colors left, and some of this paint has more and some of this paint has less PVA glue, but I really cannot tell you which one had more or less. I just tried to make them the same consistency and to stretch the colors when I had only very little color available. So just to let you know before, I cannot tell you which one had the most PVA glue and which one has the least. With the first pour, I wanted to do my almost loved black, white and gold color palette. So I grabbed these three colors, mixed them into a cup as a regular dirty pour, and I moved the paint around to make it look somewhat pretty. And the very first second already looked nice. But as soon as I stretched the paint, I could realize that the paint is going to flake and it torn itself apart. So it did not really stick together as a paint layer. It created small flakes of paint, which looked not that pretty after all. It most of the times appeared with the white, so I guess I had the most PVA glue within the white paint. And overall, it did not look really overwhelming when I had my final result of the pour. I torched it to bring up some cells. It in a way did as usual, but the cells reacted a bit strangely. So they feathered out a bit and they did not really hold their shape, which at this point I thought might become a problem, but not so much happened to the cells anyway. So I thought if these cells stay like they are right now, it could end up being somewhat nice. But that really changed. So as soon as I put the pour away and decided to let it dry and had a look at it after all the other pours that you are going to see now were done, it completely changed and the cells were feathered out and it really did not look close to somewhat pretty anymore. So I was at this point already sure that I'm not going to keep this one. I want to let it dry just to see what happens to the entire structure of the piece. So if it dries as a solid surface, if it flakes off, if it get cracks and whatsoever, so I just let it be and see what happens afterwards. The second pour, which was also a 30 by 30 centimeter canvas, was somewhat similar. So I also used the black, the white and the gold paint, and I also added a bit of the purple because I wanted to see if it looks cool if there is a fourth color into it. Normally I do not use any additional color when I do the gold ones, but you never know, perhaps it looks pretty. So I just tried it out because there was no goal intended to this one, just experimentation. And when you experiment with paint and its conditions, so to speak, why not also experimenting with different color palettes? Because probably something really pretty comes out and you can redo it with proper paint mixing. I don't know, perhaps it works out, but if not, you can just use the float wheel and redo the color palette again to make something pretty. So I added some purple and poured it. And it really looked somewhat nice, I think. I'm not sure if I really liked it to the very end, but it did not look awful at all. So probably somewhat nice. I also got some cells when I torched it, so as I usually like to have it look in the end. But you never know what comes out in the very end, so I just put it aside and let it dry as well. In the first moment, I really liked the black part of it, having the white cells showing through and the purple cells within the gold area. I did not really like to have that little white in the gold area as it looks a bit, yeah, it seems as if there are a lot of black underneath of the gold, which might turn down the thing in the end to be darker than I wanted it to be. But we will see, I will show you the result once everything is dried. The next one is again the same color mixture and it feels to be really creative when it comes to color palettes, does it? But instead of the purple, I used the copper paint. And this copper paint is also a metallic color, which really looks cool. But I never really experimented with this color before. I did many other of the same metallic color brand. But I'm not so much a fan of the reddish tones when it comes to my artworks, because I always feel like failing in the red tones. So I was a bit of afraid using the copper, although it's a beautiful, beautiful color. But yeah, again, I just tested out to see what happens here. So just again, the black, white and gold and some copper. Put it over, stretched it around and this really looked awesome. I really liked the result that came out at this point. It in a way reminded me a bit on the surface of Mars, which is cool. And I really liked the result of this. I didn't expect it to be that pretty. And well, perhaps some of you might think this looks not pretty at all. But for me, this really looks pretty because it was totally unexpected to be something like that. So that the copper is coming through that pretty, that it reacts with the other colors that nice. So I really liked this one. And as a totally useless and random side fact, I'm not sure if I told it in any other video before, but I'm a total space nerd. And Patrick is as well, and as SpaceX is going to start its mission to Mars next year in May, we are proud to be on the naming list, which is going to land on Mars if everything turns out as they plan to. And if the lander is going to land safely on Mars, we are proud to be among about 8 million people who are listed on the name list, and we will be, yeah, the first names on Mars, which is in a way so cool. So I really like Mars, and probably this is the reason why I like this artwork so much. So yeah, I like it. And as I liked it the way it was, I did not even torch it. So I put it just away to the side to let it dry as well. And when it comes to the last pour, I only had colors left that I would normally not pour together at all. It was the white and black, which of course is no issue. I had the purple and I had my metallic bluish turquoise color, which I would never usually pour together. But as these were the only paints that I had left, I just put them together in a cup and put it over, stretched it, and oh wow, it really looked cool. I really loved the effect of the purple and the turquoise color. It did not intermix, which was awesome. If it would have intermixed, it might have looked strange, odd and ugly, but this really, really turned out great. I did not torch it as well because I love the result and I really, really hoped this one is going to dry pretty and as it is like here. Like in a way I did with the copper version before. So I will put it aside as well to the other projects and tomorrow I will show you the results. So I will film it live and add it to this video here and you will see the final results of all these experiments. And in the very, very end, I'm going to show you two pictures of the final result of this pour of my two favorites. And to make this happen, I added some lines with Posca markers, which I just recently got and I really, really love them. I think these lines, which I've added and which you're going to see in a second, really improve the entire pieces. I wanted to try to get rid of some of these cracks. So in the purple one, I used the Posca markers to at least cover a part of the cracks in the purple area, which when I started thought, well, in a way, I really like these cracks, as it looks like water river lines on the planet surface and such. So I stopped correcting them. And here we are again, and total fail. Believe me, I have never seen something worse like that happening. So, it was my rest amount of paint, and I didn't just want to waste it and see if something pretty comes out. It did not. it did. In the first place, it looked kind of cool. I saw that some of the color was feathering out and was breaking apart, especially the white and the yellow, which I thought might end up ugly in the end. I didn't expect it to end up that worse because the entire paint cracked apart when it was dry, which sucked a bit. And in the first place, I really liked this color palette when it was poured and look what happened. It is completely done. So useless, unable to repair whatsoever. All there are cracks everywhere, the color is ripped apart and it just, even from distance, it does not look pretty at all. So this one will be redone. Probably I can pour something over it. There is not that much texture because the color was not that thick. I don't know yet. Probably something resin-like over it to just make it an even surface in the end. Let's see. I will of course tell you when I come up with a fitting idea for this one. Second one, this one. I really loved it when it was red. I still kind of like it, although it has really bad breakage in the color here, but I will see if I can come up with something pretty to in a way fix these gaps and crates here. I will let you know, but I have something in mind which might work and might look pretty. If it does, I will show you. If it does not, I will show you anyways and just tell you not to try fixing. I don't know. But this one I would not count to be unrepairable. So it might be, it might be. This one was my favorite at all when it was wet. And look here as well. It looks like a surfaced picture from Mars. This really cracked badly. But in a way, although this cracked, it feels like this in a way adds a bit of dramatic and interest to this one. And in a way, I'm eager to keep it because, you know, it is kind of pretty still. And I also have something in mind which might fix these crates a bit. I don't know if it will look good in the end. If it does not look good in the end, I still can waste it and put something over it. But if it helps, this might be still a pretty lovely piece to do. Probably with a resin cover in the very end to make it an even surface and not so much textured as it is now. But still kind of pretty, I think. What do you think? This one, again, I would say is a failure. It has too many cracks and the entire surface is completely ruined, I think. So I have to put something over it. Even if the cracks would have been okay and added to the piece, the entire layout in a way is not that pretty. So in the very beginning it looked kind of pretty, but these cells feathered out so much, I really did not like the end result. So this is going to be redone. Same with this one here. It also looked kind of pretty in the very beginning and I liked that these cells here had some other colors into it. So I might experiment with this a bit further, but with no added PVA glue. And overall, this piece is not as pretty when it was dried, because the gold is not that golden after all. So there was layers of black underneath, which make the entire thing look more brownish ugly. Yeah, a pity. But this one also will be redone. And yeah, so at least two possible results here, which I will see if I can fix to make them prettier. And I will show you in the end by adding a photo in the very end of the video, I think. Let's see. But so far, I hope you liked this experiment, although it was a failure again. But I have learned something new, what I should not do. So again, not adding too much PVA glue to paints. If you're new to my channel, as usual, you know the drill. Please subscribe and have a look at my other videos. I will post videos every week, three times, with whatever time I can come up with. I have acrylic pourings, I have resin art, I have realism paintings and drawings and oil paintings. And I also react to comments and questions and requests, so whatever you want to see, let me know and I will make it happen. And so far, thank you for watching. Until the next video, bye bye!